Welcome to a Breakthrough Christmas Special with your host, Pastor Rod Parsley, along with the World Harvest Church singers. Join us from the beautiful mountain resort of Seven Springs, one of the premier skiing resorts in the Northeast, as we present A Message with a Miracle.
Of winter, snowflakes falling, scent of evergreen, carols calling. You know it's time for Christmas Eve.
Cozy cottage, snowy and silver. Stars that light the night, tinsel and glitter. You know it's time for Christmas Eve. There's a song in my heart tonight. There's a love burning warm and bright. Won't you take the time to see the color lights and the sights of love? And the gift that I'm singing of, won't you come a Christmas sing with me? Windy sleigh ride, chilly and icy, golden fireside glow. Christmas Eve.
Billion memories of love and laughter, hanging of the green, dinner after. You know it's time for Christmas Eve.
There's a song in my heart tonight. There's a love burning warm and bright. Won't you take the time to see the color lights and the sights of love and the gift that I'm singing of? Won't you come a Christmas sing with me?
There's a song in my heart.
There's a love. Won't you take the time to see
the colored lights and the sights
and
of love?
And the gift that I'm singing of. Won't you come on Christmas, sing with me?
Merry Christmas. Celebrate a Savior.
Merry Christmas. Joy, 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 the Lord has come.
Well, I know you enjoyed that beautiful holiday song. We're here at Seven Springs where we're celebrating the Christmas season. We're going to have lots more music for you and lots of ministry from the Word of God. I'm going to be bringing you a message which will tell you how you can really enjoy this beautiful holiday season. We're here in Western Pennsylvania at Seven Springs, and I've got Joni with me today and Ashton, 19 months old now, and we've got a real special announcement for you on today's broadcast of Breakthrough, and that is baby number two is on the way. And I know that you're as excited as we are. And Joni, what do you think about the broadcast today?
Well, we just pray that today's broadcast will not only remind you of the joy of the Christmas season, but the joy that we hold in our hearts because of the glorious life of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We just want to wish you from our family to yours a very Merry Christmas.
Amen. You gather the family together and get your chestnuts roasting on the open fire ready there. We're going to have a tremendous time today celebrating Jesus. You join us.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but this fire is so delightful. But since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping, and I brought some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, how I hate going home in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbye. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow. Let it blizzard and bluster and blow. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Outside the snow is falling and friends are calling you. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
Giddy-up, 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 let's go. There's nothing to show. We ride through a wonderland of snow. Giddy-up, 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 it's grand. Just holding your hand. We're riding along with the song of a wintry fairyland.
Our cheeks are nice and rosy, and comfy cozy are we. We're snuggled up together like two birds of a feather would be. Let's take the road before us and sing a chorus or two. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you.
There's a Christmas party at the home of Farmer Gray. It'll be the perfect ending of a perfect day. We'll be singing the songs we love to sing without a single stop.
At the fireplace while we watch the chestnuts pop, 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 pop.
There's a happy feeling nothing in the world can buy. When they pass around the coffee and the pumpkin.
It'll nearly be like a picture print of Korea and I. These wonderful things are the things we remember all through our lives. Just hear those sleigh bells jingling, ring, ting, tingling too. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Let's take the road before us and sing a chorus or two. Come on, it's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. It's lovely weather for a sleigh ride together with you. Lovely weather for a sleigh ride
together with you.
Chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose, Yuletide carols being sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody a turkey and some mistletoe will help to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow will find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that he's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna spy to see if reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to
Noel, Noel,
Bible says if any two of you on earth agree as touching any one thing, it would be done for them by our Father which is in heaven. Joni and I want to take just a little bit of time to agree with you for your needs, and to let you reflect over the past year, the great things that the Lord has done in your life, to worship Him and to praise Him, to ask Him for those things that you need. The Bible says if you'll call upon the name of the Lord before you get His name out of your mouth, He'll be found with you. So thank the Lord and worship Him as we enter into a time of meditation on the Word of God and all of His blessings in our life. At this time of year, when they seem so near and so dear to us, we must give thanks and ask the Lord for what you have need.
Thank you. She leans with her head on the window, watching evergreens bend in the snow, remembering Christmas the way it had been so many seasons ago, when the children would reach for their stockings and open the presents they found. The lights on the tree would shine bright in their eyes, reflecting the love all around. But this year there's no one to open the gifts, no reason for trimming the tree. And just as a tear made its way to the floor, she heard voices outside start to sing. Christmas to all who dwell here. Merry Christmas, if even just one. May the joy of the season surround you. Merry Christmas with love. A caroler sang as she opened the door, faces of friends in the crowd, and all of the shadows of lonely reminders were driven away by the sound. Now the heart that for years had been silent was suddenly filled with a song. As she clung to their hands like a child in the night, she found herself singing along. Merry Christmas to all who may dwell here. Merry Christmas if even just one. Joy of the season surround you. Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas to all who may dwell here. Merry Christmas, if even just one. May the joy of the season surround you. Merry Christmas.
And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And Joseph also went up from Galilee unto the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for him in the inn.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay, but little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle are lowing, the
baby awaits. But little Lord Jesus, no crying he makes. I love thee, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky. Stay by my cradle till morning is nigh. Away in a manger, no crib for a bed. The little Lord Jesus lay down sweet head. The stars in the sky look down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. Away in a manger, away. For the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. Jesus, and love me, I pray.
Shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the baby Jesus lying in a manger.
thy birth. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender.
What a tremendous time we're having on today's broadcast of Breakthrough. And I really hope that you're enjoying this Christmas special. We wanted it to be special for you as you're celebrating this wonderful time of year when we celebrate that God sent into the world in the likeness of sinful flesh His own Son, that we who were under the law might be redeemed from the law, set at liberty, our sins cast as far as the east is from the west, never to be remembered against us again. And I don't want you to be caught up in religious tradition. I don't want you just to get caught up on today's broadcast of just thinking about a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes and laid in a manger. For that was only the entry point. And I'm so thankful, as I know you are, that Jesus didn't stay a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, but He grew. He went from a little child to a young man. And as a young man, He began His ministry at 30 years of age. He went out to preach this gospel of the kingdom, anointed of the Holy Ghost, baptized by John in the River Jordan. And when He came up out of the water, the Bible said the Spirit of the Lord descended out of heaven in a form like as of a dove and lighted upon Him. And God said, "This is my beloved Son. Hear ye Him, for in Him I am well pleased." I want you to hear the message coming from the cradle in Bethlehem into your heart today. Wherever you are and whatever you're doing, God sent His Son into the world for you. But He didn't just stay a young man. He went on to a place just outside Jerusalem called Golgotha, the place of the skull. There He had His beard plucked from His face. There this little baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, now a mature man, was beaten, was spit upon, was ridiculed, was prodded through the cobblestone streets of Jerusalem. They hanged Him on an old rugged cross on a hill far away. He was swung up between heaven and earth, and there He became the supreme sacrifice, the propitiation for your sins and for mine, for the transgressions of mankind, for every sin which you have ever committed, any sin which you ever will commit. The sins of the world were laid upon Him, and not that only, but sickness and disease and poverty and infirmity and loneliness and sorrow and desperation were laid upon Jesus. And there swung up between heaven and hell the pitiful Palestinian sun, beat down into His open wounds until it felt as though the very flames of hell had embedded themselves in the flesh of the only begotten Son of God. But I'm so thankful He didn't stay on this cross, for they raised it up out of the ground, and it fell over with a thud with the body of the Prince of God. Mary Magdalene, out of whom Jesus had cast seven devils, took her comb and began to brush His blood-soaked matted hair. They wrapped Him in grave clothes and laid Him in the borrowed tomb of Joseph of Arimathea. And there He lay for 3 days. For 3 days. But on the third day, the stone got rolled away. And an angel said, "Mary, go and tell. The Son of God is risen. Hallelujah. Jesus is alive and well. He raised from the dead, victorious over death, victorious over hell, victorious over the grave, to give you victory and to give me victory." So we've got to get Jesus out of Bethlehem's manger, and we've got to take Him through Calvary, and we've got to see Him on resurrection morning. But not only there, He said, "I go away to prepare a place for you, that where I am, there you may be also. And if I go away, I will come again, and I will receive you unto myself." himself. Jesus is coming very, very soon. I don't know how many more holiday seasons like this we'll have. Perhaps you're there with your family. Perhaps some of them have gone on to be with the Lord even this year. You know, this word says tomorrow's promised to no man. And every year at Christmas, I'm reminded that the family circle gets smaller and smaller on this side of glory. But thanks be to God, because Jesus came and was born in that manger in Bethlehem and went through Calvary and rose again from the dead, there's coming a day when the circle will not be unbroken. Grandma, you may be lonely right now at Christmas time, but I've got good news for you. This gospel brings you good news right now. We're going to be together again one day. We're going to leap like a hart over the everlasting hills of God, to grow old no more, to suffer no more, to sorrow no more, to die no more, because greater is he that is in us than he that's in the world. That's the message that Jesus came to bring. He didn't come to bring us some religious holiday where we just give gifts to one another. He came, the Bible said in Galatians chapter 4, in the fullness of time, that we who were born under the curse might be freed from the curse. Galatians 3:13 said, he hath redeemed us from the curse of the law. For it is written, cursed is anyone that hangeth upon a tree, that the blessing of Abraham might come upon the Gentiles through faith. If you'll have faith in him today, you'll know that resurrection power in your life. Jesus did come in the fullness of time. The Bible said when all things were in order, God sent his son. In the time in which Jesus came, there was the greatest roadway system ever in the history of the world. Even to this day, the Roman road systems are used for travel. And you say, well, why is that important? Well, it's important because God said through the prophet Micah, 750 years. Now, if you want to know if what we're speaking to you is truth, if you want to know if what I'm telling you is true, this book has stood through hundreds of years because it is accurate in its predictions. Everything that it says comes to pass. It is the oak of God planted in the forest of eternity. It entwines its roots around the rock of ages. And better people than you and I have pillowed their head on it in their dying hour. You can trust the word of God when everything else around you is sinking and sliding and the economy is topsy-turvy and friends and relationships are crumbling all around you. You can anchor. You can anchor. Did you hear me? On the word of God. 750 years before Jesus was born in that Bethlehem stable, the prophet Micah stood up and began to prophesy. And he said the Savior of the world would be born in Bethlehem of Judea. Well, that was pretty hard to do, seeing that Mary lived a great distance away. How was God going to get this virgin espoused to Joseph, now conceived the Son of the living God by the power of the Holy Ghost? How was he going to get her to the place where she was to be born according to prophecy? Well, he did it because he brought into being the greatest roadway systems ever known to the human family, so that when Mary and Joseph came to be taxed, you see, there again, the greatest system of taxation, a global taxation system set up by the Romans, which said you had to return to the ancestral home of your forefathers. For Mary and Joseph, they were living in Nazareth, but their home, their ancestral home, was in Bethlehem. And so this taxation system was not put in. You know, the Bible said the heart of the king is in the hand of the Lord, and God's going to do whatever it takes to get your miracle to you. He had Micah prophesy 750 years before he was ever born that he would be born in Bethlehem. Then he brought the Romans on the scene, built the roads, and put on the system of taxation to bring Jesus to that stable in Bethlehem of Judea. He was born there. Hark, the herald angels sang, glory to God, the newborn king. They came from all over the world bearing gifts and ministering unto the Lord. He brought miracle-working power to the earth. I want you to know this Jesus has the answer for your need right now. And I would be remiss if I just came to you and brought you holiday songs and made you feel real warm in your heart, because you may be empty right now. You know, there are more suicides during the Christmas season than any other time during the year. Some of you that I'm talking to right now are depressed. You're distracted. You're lonely. You feel like nobody cares about you. You say, where's the joy of Christmas? I'll tell you where the joy of Christmas is. It's accepting the Christ of Christmas. Jesus came in the fullness of time. But your reception of him must come in the fullness of time. You see, folks want to say, well, I'll accept Jesus whenever I want to. I'm a young man. I've got a lot of years left. I'm moving in my business. Things are going right in my life, and I don't want to turn to Jesus right now. Let me share something with you, sir. The Bible says today is the day of salvation. Right now is the appointed time. And even as Jesus, as God the Father, brought all things into congruency to bring Jesus' birth into the earth at exactly the right time, Jesus has you right now watching this broadcast. He has you right where you are, hearing the words that you're hearing. He had you buy that television set so you could hear this broadcast today. He had us prepare this program especially for you, to meet you right at the point of your need. Your life has been a series of seemingly insignificant events which have brought you to the place where you are seated or you are standing right now, hearing what you are hearing. I was born into the earth. God prepared my life to have me speak these words to you today. And we're meeting right now. This is no ordinary time. This is the fullness of time. This is the dedicated time of God. This is the time when God reaches out and takes your heart into his hands and says, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Jesus is reaching out to you right now. Now's the fullness of time. The Bible said, harden not your heart, as did your forefathers in the day of provocation. For if you do, you'll only become good at hardening your heart. And he that hardens his heart, listen, shall be cut off. Oh my God. Shall be cut off from the Christ of Christmas. Shall be cut off from the Christ of Calvary. Shall be cut off from everything that God prepared for humanity from the foundation of the world. Don't let that be you. Don't be cut off. Don't harden your heart. Today is the fullness of time. Today is the appointed time. Today is the day of salvation. Every year at this time, when the snow is falling and the winter crisp is in the air, I'm reminded of just over a year ago at this time, my very best friend, a first cousin named Freddie, was in our service at World Harvest Church. He had his hands raised, and before the service began, I walked up to him and I shook hands with him. He was standing there weeping. He was a big man, and he drove a truck, had a beard. He was a woodsman, and his tears were running down, dripping off of his face. And as his tears were dripping off of his face, worshiping the living God at 20 minutes after 7 on a Sunday night, I thought how wonderful the Christ of Christmas and Calvary is, that he could change a man's life, that he could give joy unspeakable and full of glory, that he could make all the difference, just like he can make for you. Well, I went on with the service. The next morning, just after 7 o'clock, I got a phone call to come to the county morgue and identify a body. As I walked in, I had no doubt who it was. As they pulled the sheet back from his face, my 29-year-old best friend had been driving down an icy road. A young man had an epileptic seizure, came across the center line and hit him head on, and instantly, Freddie went out to meet with the Lord. I preached his funeral service. It was a hard thing to do. And as I preached that funeral service, I noticed a young man back in the congregation that looked a lot like Freddie. He too was overweight and he had a beard and he was weeping and sobbing also. At the end of the funeral service, he came up to the altar to pay his respects to Freddie. And as he stood there, I joined hands with him and I asked him his name, and he said, I'm Big Tom. I said, Big Tom, kneel down right here. Give your life to Jesus. Today's the day of salvation. Now's the appointed time. Give your life to Jesus and you'll see Freddie again. He wept, began to bend his knee. Suddenly he let go of the casket and turned around and ran out the back of that 5,200-seat auditorium. I never saw him again. 2 weeks later, I got a phone call. If we could have a funeral service at World Harvest Church. I said, certainly. They said, you know the deceased. He's Big Tom. At 29 years of age, driving a tractor trailer, he went off the road over slick embankment, crashed head on into a concrete embankment. The 18-wheeler burst into flames, and immediately Big Tom went out to be with Jesus. You see, here's the point of Christmas. Jesus came to seek and to save that which was lost. He said, I came into the world to redeem the world. John 3:16 said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever would believe upon him would not perish but have everlasting life. For God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Two 29-year-old young men, both with beards,
both overweight, right now at this moment, one is rejoicing in the glories of God's heaven, and one is spending eternity separated from God in a place called hell. The difference? One accepted the Christ of Christmas. One rejected him. What will you do today? What will you do with Jesus? Will you just celebrate by giving presents to one another, or will you allow God to give you the greatest present any human being could ever receive, eternal life through the shed blood of Jesus Christ? Let him change your life right now. Pray this prayer with me. Right there where you are, join hands with someone. I see you. I see you weeping. I see the Spirit of God moving on you. This is going to be the greatest Christmas you ever had in your life right now. Pray this prayer with me. Lord Jesus Christ, come into my heart. Forgive my sins. Become my Savior. Give me eternal life. In Jesus' name, amen. Right now, right now, pick up that phone. Dial the number that's on your screen and allow someone to pray with you. And you're going to celebrate the rest of this Christmas special with us, knowing that you're as sure for heaven as if you were already there. God bless you.
Lift up your heads, no need to mourn. His hand is stretched out still, for unto us a child is born, his promise to fulfill. Jerusalem, he cried for you. He did not come to you in vain.
We'll never grow dear.
that was born there. He's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, and He will come
again. Master, Redeemer, Savior of the world, Wonderful Counselor, Bright Morning Star, Lily of the Valley, Provider. Today he'll be tomorrow, the beginning and the end. And the angel called him Jesus, born of a darkness, my door to heaven, my home in the sky, the fountain of living water that never shall run dry. And the angel called him Jesus, but I
What a great time we've had on our holiday special. I hope that it's been as much a blessing to you as it was to us bringing it to you. We've had a tremendous time here because we've got to tell you what we like to tell you best, and that is Jesus Christ of Nazareth is Lord, the devil is defeated, and this can be the greatest holiday season of your life. We pray that this holiday season finds you healthy and happy and flowing in the love and the anointing of the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't let anyone or anything deter you from everything God wants this holiday season to be for you. So from all of us, the crew and the family here at World Harvest Church and Breakthrough, have a very happy holiday season.
Christmas decorations provided by the Christmas Cottage in Columbus, Ohio. Lodging and interior set provided by the Bethman Family Retreat. Outdoor locations provided by Seven Springs Mountain Resort, Champion, Pennsylvania. Breakthrough Christmas Special was made possible by the prayers and support of you, our faithful partners.